Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Altcoin Reviews. Today I am here with one more video on arbitraging, and the topic of today's video is frequently asked questions, and this is the part 2 of my previous video which I was making on the topic of security. Let me move to the topic security. This is the topic on which I was making the video and I explained two questions in it. This is the security tab, as you can see here. I explained the question number 1 and the question number 2, and there were still 3 questions left and the time was up. The video was already 12 minutes long, so I thought if I will keep on going, the video will get to 20-30 minutes, and it's not a good thing to make these long videos. And the video editor which I am using, it only allows me to make a video of maximum 15 minutes. I am thinking to change my video editor soon so I can make a bit longer video also, but for now you have to bear with me on this. And plus, people also don't like to see a 30-40 minutes long video. They like to see 10-12 minutes, it's good for them. But if I extend my video to 20-30 minutes, people will get bored. So I tried to divide my video in few parts. I keep it maximum 12-13 minutes, no go longer than that. And that's why if some video is bigger, so I divide it in 2-3 parts. If there is a 30 minute video, I divide it in 3 parts, 10-10 minutes each. So it gets short and simple. Usually people don't like to watch such long videos because it's not a movie. I am just explaining things, and if the explanation goes too long, it looks like a long lecture and people get bored. So I try to keep them short. Okay, so let's start the question number 3, and I try to finish these 3 questions in this single video. Okay, so it only get to 2 parts. I don't want to make it much longer. Okay, so it's the security. I already explained the 2 questions, and then now the question number 3 is there a way to save my 2FA code if didn't write down when setting up? It's same thing happened with me also. When I save and when I was setting my 2FA, I didn't save my code. So what I did is same thing is explained here, that if you don't save your 2FA data, then you can do so by following these simple steps. Okay, if you have not saved it, no need to worry, you can do it now. It will only take 2-3 minutes of your precious time. So what you have to do is log into your ARB account, go inside the account tab and turn off the 2FA. Okay, delete the arbitraging.co 2FA on your phone. Okay, but do not stop after that. Turn it on again instantly. You don't keep your 2FA off for a longer, because it will not take 2-3 minutes time. So do it in one go. Don't do like this, that you do 2 steps, turn off and go away, and you thought that I will do the other steps after coming back, because it will make your account unsafe for a period of time. So do all the following steps in a single go, so you also get safe. First step, you need to log into your Arbitrage account. Second step, you need to turn off the 2FA by going into your account tab. Third step, you have to delete the arbitraging.co 2FA on the Google Authenticator app on your phone. Now you have to go to the number 4 step is, you have to go to your account tab again and turn on the 2FA again. Now, save the 2FA QR code. The QR code which it will show there, which you scan from your mobile phone camera on the Google 2-factor authorization authenticator software, save it by taking a screenshot on your computer if you want it. If you want to save it in your USB, Google Drive, or you want to make a hard copy or print it out, whatever you have to do, save that QR code before taking a snap on your mobile, or before scanning it on your mobile, you save that QR code. then activate again on your cell phone or computer. Okay, and there is one more software which is Authy. It is also highly recommendable. Okay, it automatically backs up your 2FA barcodes in the cloud. There is an Authy app you can download if you want to use that over the Google 2FA. Your 2FA should be open again. Okay, now I hope you will understand that only thing you need to do before turning on the 2FA, you have to save that QR code, because that QR code will, you will be able to use it again when, if you lost your phone, or if your phone get stolen, or if your phone get damaged and you get a new phone and you want to make 2FA again. So what you will simply do is, in the new phone you will download the Google authentication app and you just simply scan that barcode and your 2-factor will be transferred to your new phone. That's as simple as that. Okay, now let's move to the question number 4, which is the second last question. Do you have an ARP online security manual? Now it is said that an ARP member wrote this for arbitraging.co. He has run his own business as an internet security expert for many years. Let me open this in new tab and let's see what it is. It is loading. Let it load. So basically this is the ARP manual for security. Some of the member wrote this, okay, and he is doing his own business and as a security expert from many years. Okay, so this manual he has wrote, you can go to this link and read out this and you will understand. But you first you have to ask for the permission from the maker of this manual. You have to click on the request button and it will send a request to the person who created that Google Docs and he will allow you, then you can read it. I tried it but it says access denied. First I have to request for the access to see that page, then I will able to see it. So if you want to see this, you can click on request access and it will send the email to the owner of this manual, and when he will allow us, then we will be able to see it. Now let's move to the last question, and it is a very important question, that in Telegram chat, how do I tell a real admin from a scammer impersonating an admin? Okay, so this question says that how do I tell a real admin that there is a scammer who is trying to be making himself as an admin or showing him as an admin to me. Okay, so it's an important question that if someone you interact and he is showing himself as an admin but he is a scammer, so how you can go and complain to the real admin. So there are three steps in which it has explained that number one, real admin will never PM you first. Scammer must contact you first. They have no choice. On that fact alone, you can easily tell the difference, but make no mistake, they are very convincing liars when they contacting you that they are an admin. You never, there is one simple rule. If you follow this, you will never get a scam. No admin will ever message. Do Google message you? Do Facebook message you by himself? If you have some problem with Facebook, you contact the Facebook support. If you have some problem with Google, YouTube, or any business in the world, if you have some problem, you go yourself and complain them. Don't, no one from their team will contact you by themselves. If the problem is related to them, then they will contact you. But if you have the problem, you must go and register your complaint. If let's say if your mobile phone's cell phone get stolen, what you will do? You will go to the police station and file a complaint against that. So no police will come to you directly to ask you if your mobile phone has got stolen. So same works here. that if the problem is yours, you have to contact the admin. If someone else is trying to contact you, this means he is a scammer. In the chat, a real admin has an admin to the right of their name when they make a comment. Left click on their picture to PM them. Always a real admin will have a admin solo or symbol in front of their name, right side of their name. So if there is no admin written right side of their name, this means they are a scam. Search, or maybe it's a normal member. Search member list in the chat. A real admin has a star or admin next to their name in that list. When you click on that group, there will be a list of members will come, and there will be an admin sign in front of that person name, or there will be a star. If there is no admin sign or no star, this means he is not the admin. Anyone that PMs you first claiming to be an admin is a scammer. No ARB admin has official support or admin in their name, nor they have ever PM you first. Admins are forbidden from doing so. No admin will ever request you in any form of currency to rectify your problem. This means no admins have any kind of support or admin symbol in front of their name. Oh, no admin has official or support in front of their name. It only shows admin as an admin of their of that group. Okay, they will not add admin to their name, so keep in mind, and they will never ask you for the money to solve your problem. Keep that in mind also. We also have shillers, that is people pushing other platforms. Anyone that randomly PM you frequently asks, frequently starting with hi, how are you or similar, is a such person. Immediately notify an admin. If someone message you from the Telegram from this same room to your personal message like hi, how are you or something like that, he is someone who is promoting other program, or he is also a scammer. You should go and complain that to the admin of the Telegram room that this person is trying to message me, please block this person from the room. Be sure to PM an admin and supply a screenshot of this person's conversation with you. They cannot be banned from the chat without the proof. When you PM the admin, make sure that you also attach a snapshot of your conversation with them so they can block them. The next step for you is to block the user also and report as a spam. You also block that person from your Telegram and report as a scam, so Telegram also revoke their account. Be safe. This is the example of the scammer they have showed in this image. Let me zoom in. As you can see, that is Clark Ban Hammer Bam send message. They are saying this is an example that you, when you send message, this is the clear example of that. Okay. Sorry, let me open it. There is one more image. I opened the other one. Okay, here you can see it. Sorry, the picture quality of these two images is very bad. So when I am zooming it, the pixels are getting broken. That's why I am not able to show it properly. You can go to this page yourself and see these images. Then you will see that these are the two examples of admin. I am just showing it from here that you can report them from here. Okay, and they will get deleted from the Telegram. Oh my god, the video is already 14 minutes long, and in the start of that video I was talking about to make this short and simple video. So let's end it here. It's already too late. So let me end it here. Thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you like it, share it, comment it, and subscribe to my channel. Have a very wonderful day. Bye bye.